God's glory in the house. Let's give God's glory in the house. I had nothing to do with waking you up this morning. I had nothing to do with putting you in your right mind. I said we ought to give God some glory in the house. Truly indeed, we do give honor to the Spirit of Christ in this place.
Yes.
Give honor to the bishop and pastor of this establishment. Also to all your ministerial alliances.
Glory,
to all of you in your respective places.
Yes.
God bless you in his own way. The book of Genesis chapter 2, verses 16 and 17. The book of Genesis chapter 2, verses 16 and 17. And then we'll conclude in the book of the same book, chapter 3, the first four verses.
Glory.
Once again, our primary scripture reading will begin in the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verses 16 and 17. And I will conclude in the third book of the same, the third chapter of the same book, verses 1 through 4. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Genesis chapter 2. Genesis chapter 2, 16 and 17. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. For in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die.
Amen.
Chapter 3, the first four verses. And now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, has God indeed said, you should not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God had said, you should not eat it, nor should you touch it, lest you die. Then the serpent said to the woman, you will not surely die. Came to tell you that the devil lied to me.
Uh-huh.
But Jesus told me the truth.
Uh-huh.
The devil lied to me.
Uh-huh.
But Jesus told me the truth.
Uh-huh.
Ever since the beginning of time, before man was even made, wow, when God created Lucifer, he was a wonderful created being. But he got to the point where he wanted to exalt himself before God. He wanted God's glory. And when God cast him and his angels out of heaven, Lucifer, Satan, the devil, talking about the same created being, always had it out for God. And what better way to take revenge on God than to take it out on his created beings?
That's right.
When Satan lied to Eve, as he lies to us right now, it is not only for us to disobey God, but he also lies to us so we can lose trust in God. Now, this part of the message would disclose how false prophets and preachers and Christian leaders tell lies. They say that once saved, it's always saved. Well, this came from a Calvinistic view. John Calvin was a theologian in the 1500s, and he established this theory that if you ever believe in Christ and confess your sins, really doesn't matter how you live, you're going to heaven. But the problem with this lie is that, and it was stated earlier, that the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. So I'm here to tell you, if you die in a hypocritical state, in a backsliding state, if you die in your sins, where Jesus is, you cannot go. During the time of Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection, when the angels came and rolled the stone away, the guards that were standing by fell as dead men. And when it was reported that Jesus was not in the tomb, the Roman government paid the Roman soldiers to tell a lie, to say that his disciples came by night and stole his body. But the problem with that is saying that Jesus never really resurrected. Or it even calls Jesus a lie, because Jesus said, destroy this temple, and I'll raise it up again. So that's the problem with that. People like to say that God understands you are human. Is this okay to subject yourself to human gratification? But see, the Bible says that there is no temptation that God will not allow you to overcome. He will always make a way for you to escape. That's why apostle, you got to die daily. Yeah, is this another lie that says God is too loving to send you to hell? Well, the problem with that lie is because in the book of Revelation, along with some other things, it say liars will also have their part in the lake of fire. Now, in this part of the message, I will tell you how we lie over God. People say, God called me to preach. Yeah. Well, when you talk to the average preacher that was called by God, he or she really didn't want to preach. They ran from it. Yeah, they really didn't want to preach. And you mean to tell me God called you to preach, but you can never preach salvation, sanctification, receiving of the Holy Spirit? Yeah. Some people lie and say, well, God told me to do this in the ministry. God told me to confront this person. Well, why are we having so many shipwrecks if God had instructed you to do such a task? And then if you are in a ministry and God has instructed you to perform a certain task, the right thing for you to do is take it up with your pastor.
Amen.
And if God had called you to do such a thing, the pastor will have an agreeing spirit with you. People will tell, say that the Lord sent me to the pastor to ask for money to pay my bills. The Lord told me to go to the church to the deacon board to ask for money. Well, I don't understand that. You ask the church for money, but you've gone to church 3 and 4 years and you don't pay tithes and offerings. The Bible says, bring all your tithes and offerings to the storehouse, that there will be meat in my house. If you put nothing in your refrigerator, when you open the door, you receive nothing. The reason why people draw Social Security, because they put in. Yeah, they put in Social Security. This is another lie that people lie on God. God told me that you're going to be my wife. God told you that you're going to be my husband. There was a young lady that I worked with, and she said a co-worker told her that God said, you're going to be my wife. She said, well, God didn't tell me that. I believe God is a gentleman. If he told someone that you're going to be their spouse, I believe God will also consult with that person as well. Now, this part of the message will tell how we lie to God. Yeah. You don't believe we lie to God? In the Bible, when Cain killed Abel, God asked Cain, where is your brother? He said, I don't know. Lie directly to God. How we lie to God? We pray, we fast, we meditate, we tell God, I trust you. As soon as we get off our knees, we go in doubt. And we just told God we trust him. Yeah. We tell God, I put you first. But we lie because we put our spouses first, we put our jobs first, we put our children first, we put our money first.
All right.
Yeah. We sing the song, my hope is built on nothing less. Jesus, blood, and righteousness. Mm-hmm. Your hope is built on Powerball, Mega Millions, Pick 3, Pick 4, the scratch up. I'm just telling you where your hope is at. We lie to God and say, if you heal me, if you deliver me, if you bring me out this mess, I'll serve you. As soon as God heals you, you go back to doing the same thing that caused your infirmity. As soon as he delivers you, you go back to the same crowd. You go back to being in jail. But you tell God, you pray, God, I won't go back to do such things. Now, these are how lies affect people. Lies have destroyed marriages. Lies have destroyed homes, families. Lies have caused people to be in jail. Lies have caused jobs, have caused friendships, and people have killed because of being deceived. When you go on black people, meetblackpeople.com, plenty of fish, eHarmony, all these different things. If you show a picture where you wear 150 pounds, a picture about 10 years old, and your hair is down to your shoulder, and you go meet the person, and you double your weight, or your hair is lower than my haircut, people will kill you because you deceive them.
Yeah.
Now, in this part of the message, I will give you several lies orchestrated by the devil. And these lies have led people to secure a certain action or way of thinking. The devil will tell a woman, hey, you ain't no good. That woman will start liking women. The devil will tell a man, all the women out there ain't no good. That man will start liking men because he feels no woman out there no good. Just because two or three preachers not living right, the devil will tell you, ain't none of the preachers living
right.
Ain't nobody in the church saved. And then you detest the church. You won't go to church. Now, this part of this message deal with testimony. There was a couple in the Bible named by Ananias and Sapphira. Husband and wife. During that particular time, when people had sold their possessions, they would donate the monies to the apostles, and the apostles would distribute those funds to the needy churches or needy people in the community.
Amen.
Well, Ananias and his wife conspired to sell a possession, but they lied about how much money they made of it. And they didn't have to, because they didn't have to sell the possession. There wasn't a requirement. So when they went to the apostle, well, Ananias went first, the husband went first. And Peter said, have you sold the possession for so much? And he said, yes. Peter said, why have you allowed Satan to fill your heart and you lied to the Holy Spirit? Right then and there, Ananias died. About 3 hours later, his wife came with the same conspiracy. She lied and she died. Oh, you have people testify, I love everybody. And as soon as the benediction is given, you go through one door so you won't have to speak to a certain pigeon. You tell or you testify, people have done me wrong, but I have a forgiving spirit. As soon as you run across someone that have wronged you 5 or 10 years, you get something in your spirit because you want to do something to that person. But you just testify and say you forgive the person. We testify and say, for God I live, and for God I die. And when you clock in Monday morning, you raise more sin than the average son of a child. We lie and we say we treat everybody right. But as soon as church is over, you call somebody and say, did you see that dress that sister had on? Did you see that dirty shirt that brother had on today? So at the beginning, even until now, the devil has lied and is still lying for us to turn away from God. Some of you are sick right now, and the devil is telling you that you can't be healed. But the truth of the matter is that he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace is upon him, and with his stripes, high blood pressure got to come down. With his stripes, low blood pressure got to come up. With his stripes, cancer got to bag up. With his stripes, arthritis and rheumatism can't stand a chance. The devil is trying to make you feel that in your situation, in your circumstance, that you can't have peace. But the Bible says, if your mind stays on him, he will give you perfect peace. He will give you the peace that will surpass all understanding. I don't understand what's going on in my life, but I got peace. I don't know why they tripping on the job, but I got peace. The devil will tell you that no one loves you, but the truth of the matter is that God so loved the world. When the Bible said no weapon formed against you shall prosper, the devil can aim, but it's going to be a misfire. The devil can aim, but it's going to ricochet. The devil can aim, but he won't shoot blanks. The enemy wants you to know that you will never make it. He tries to scare you with your situation, but you got to tell the devil,
righteous, weeping and doing for a righteous.
So wickedly that you can't get saved because of your background, because your dad was an alcoholic, because your mom was a homer, because your dad was in the street, that you can't get saved because of who you are, because of what you look like. You can't get saved. But the Bible said, if you believe within your heart and confess Jesus Christ with your mouth, thou shalt be saved. Drop down on your knees and say, Lord, save me. Lord, have mercy on me. You believe it, you can receive it and confess it. Thou shalt be saved. You never lied to me, but Jesus told me the truth. Told me I can make it. I'm going to throw a nugget at you, young people. The devil is jealous of you because you got a chance to make it to heaven. He does not. That's why he's after you. That's why he's after you. That's why you got the bullies after you. Because they know your potential. That's why you got the government after you. Because they know your potential. But the devil is a liar. So despite your background, despite the shoes you wear,
glory,
despite your clothes, maybe you're not in a mother father home, but you know some of the best people come out of single parent home. Don't you know some of the best citizens come from foster parent homes? Don't you watch the news when you have the serial killers? They say, I don't know what happened. He was reared in a Christian home. Even we went to church. Well, the devil's a liar. He got tired of church. That's what happened. We church out. That's the same thing with these baby dedications. We have the baby dedications, and everybody looks so good, dressed in white. Then we have a big evening after church, and we believe that the devil, that the baby's going to be covered under the blood, and he shall be covered. But you got to go beyond the baby dedication. You got to continue to bring that child to the church. You got to continue to live a life before that child. You got to continue and teach that child. So the devil is telling you, all you got to do is bring them to the dedication, and he's going to heaven. All you got to do is have a baby dedication. They ain't always be covered, but you got work you got to do. Despite what you have done in your life, the devil may tell you you're not even worthy. You're not even fit.
Jesus.
That's the case. None of us are fit for him.
My Lord, my Lord. Right.
And because of his grace,
Hallelujah.
Devil will lie to you and say, you say you ain't cool. No, I'm saved. I'm cool.
Yeah.
I'm hip. I'm all right. I think so.
Yeah.
And I'm saved, sanctified, holy, and good. I ain't dragged down. I'm happy. I got joy.
Yes.
Y'all looking for God to beat now?
No.
Okay. That's what the truth does for you.
Yes. Jesus.
That's what the truth
does. Amen.
So, Lord, this morning I'm inviting you, despite how you may feel about yourself. Sometimes no matter how you feel about yourself. Despite the lies that were ever told to you, you're not going to make it. You're not going to make anything. You don't know who your dad is. Your mom ain't no good. Or your dad and your mom together, but they separated in the same house. You see a lot of stuff. You got to look at a lot of stuff. The Bible says, save yourself from this untoward generation. You got to get to the point where you got to save your own self. Somebody is living saved. Preachers, some of you got preachers that are living right. Don't let the devil fool you that ain't nobody in the church living right. Ain't none of the preachers living right. If they ain't living right, what devil might lie to you and say, you don't need to come to prayer. You're a good old boy. You're a good old girl. You don't bother nobody. But still, you need to be saved.
Yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Devil can tell, I'm going to have to live with this. I'll never be delivered from this. But the devil's alive.
Amen. Glory.
And then, there's a scripture for that. Some things we do have to live with, but God said, my grace is sufficient. Paul says, a thorn in my side. I don't mean about this thing. I went to the Lord three times to take him out. Job, got a problem in my physical life, got a problem in my home. I went to the Lord three times, but he said, my grace, let me while I'm going through this thing. You remember when Jacob wrestled with the angel, he went with a limp. He didn't even limp because he was handicapped. It was evidence that he'd been with the Lord. So you see me limp, I ain't handicapped. I'm the pastor coming for you, but I invite you to stop allowing the enemy to deceive you.
Right.
And the truth is that God loves you. He loves you so much that he died for you. And if you can just believe and receive him, you can reign with him into eternal glory. God bless you.